You know, I've had a change of heart. Unlike everyone on the right, I don't want the Mueller investigation to end so soon. I want it to keep going on and on and on. Because every day it gets closer to proving Russia collusion. The collusion, however, with Russia and Team Obama, not Trump. Whether it's Hillary's reset button, the sale of 20% of our uranium to Russia with a $145 million payback to the Clinton Foundation, or the fact that the Obama administration watched as Russia annexed Crimea and then invaded Ukraine, while Barack Obama whispered in that off-mic moment, quote, tell Vlad I'll have more leeway after, or flexibility after the election. Or whether you even believe Barack told Putin when he became aware of Russians' attempt to meddle to knock it off. Or when Obama weaponized the intelligence community to unmask Trump people like Michael Flynn, Carter Page, and others. The truth is, every day we get to watch the evidence of the framing of Donald Trump exposed. This week, The Hill's John Solomon broke yet another explosive story of anti-Trump conspiracy. Now, we all know Hillary Clinton and the DNC gave millions to an opposition research firm, Fusion GPS, that then hired Christopher Steele to create dirt on Donald Trump in order to surveil his campaign. To this day, we still haven't heard why a FISA court judge would even consider signing a surveillance warrant based upon this fraudulent document. But what no one seems to be talking about is that this same dossier is the basis of the Mueller investigation itself. Right after his election, mind you, after Donald Trump's win, the head of Fusion GPS meets with a top Justice Department official, Bruce Orr. 2 days later, Orr, Rod Rosenstein's right hand, takes the information from Fusion back to the DOJ and gives it to the FBI, setting off the beginning of the Mueller investigation. Now, a Russia collusion criminal investigation. Christopher Steele, of course, terminated by the FBI for leaking information to the media. Yet, even after the election and his dismissal, he continues to meet and speak with Bruce Orr, who takes this information from a source he is not allowed to work with. Orr then launders it, feeds it to justice and the FBI, and then he amazingly tries to get the discredited Steele back into the FBI as a human source. So why would Orr, after back-channeling information with Steele, a fired FBI human source, work so hard to get Steele back into the FBI? Think about the timing. There's only one reason Steele is the one person who supports the inaccurate, unverified dossier. Even Comey said it was unverified. But in order to get the Department of Justice and FBI interested in a new criminal Trump-Russia collusion investigation, it was essential that Steele be back in their good graces. And by the way, if you think Peter Strzok and Lisa Page hated Donald Trump, folks, meet Christopher Steele, a discredited FBI source trying desperately to get on Mueller's destroyed Trump team. Pirro struck another Trump hater, although he admits there was no there, also seeks and gets on the Mueller team. So, Team Mueller, have on it. The more you investigate, procrastinate, and fail to find evidence of Trump-Russia collusion, the more you become hoisted by your own petard. But, Bob, my question's to you. How could you possibly be investigating Donald Trump when there is absolutely no credible basis for your investigation? And what the hell have you and your Trump-hating, conflicted team of prosecutors come up with in the last 19 months other than a tax evasion case that doesn't involve Donald Trump, Russia, or collusion of any sort and should be prosecuted by a regular U.S. attorney's office and not you? But more important, Bob, is what you're hiding and protecting as you continue with your fraudulent investigation. Permit me. In 2009, a Russian oligarch named Deripaska was asked by the FBI to give millions of his own money to fund an FBI operation. The man running the FBI, Bob? You. The man courting the Russian oligarch for money was Andrew McCabe, deputy director of the FBI, now since fired. Now, Bob, in spite of the fact that Deripaska had been banished by the United States 3 years earlier in 2006 because of his organized crime affiliations, your FBI asks him to fund one of your operations? But more important, after Donald Trump is elected, Deripaska is asked by the FBI to help corroborate the Steele dossier? Deripaska himself scoffed at the idea that Trump colluded with Russia. Quote, you're trying to create something out of nothing. Fast forward 9 years later, and you indict Paul Manafort. But one name is left out of that indictment. Bob, your indictment makes no mention of Deripaska, even though you had evidence that Manafort wanted to invite him to a Trump campaign briefing. So my question to you, Bob Mueller, would be as follows. Are you using the Christopher Steele fake dossier as the basis of your investigation? What crime are you investigating? Did you know Bruce Orr and Christopher Steele communicated directly, although surreptitiously, after Steele was fired? Was Bruce Orr working with you, getting information to you? And of course, you know Bruce's wife, Nellie, was getting paid for and working for Fusion GPS. Have you investigated that conflict? And speaking of wives making money off their husbands in DOJ and FBI, have you investigated Andrew McCabe's wife for the money she took from the Clinton-connected McAuliffe for her campaign, which money she could keep if she didn't spend them? And why did you give a special security clearance to Peter Strzok, allowing him to declassify information? Why did it take us 4 months to find out why you fired Peter Strzok? Why would you ask for millions of dollars from a Russian oligarch banned from the United States to fund an FBI operation? Should you even have asked the oligarch for tens of millions of dollars and for his services? Because that's a crime, isn't it, Bob? I'm sure you know the Anti-Deficiency Act prohibits you as a government agency from accepting voluntary services. And if it came out that you took money, Bob, from a Russian oligarch whose name you intentionally left out of Manafort's indictment, that would be an embarrassment, wouldn't it? Isn't that why you never put his name in the Manafort indictment? And by the way, isn't this a classic conflict of interest? And when Deripaska laughed at the idea of Trump collusion with Russia, was that exculpatory information conveyed to the FISA court? Aren't you worried that your prior actions with Deripaska are worthy of its own grand jury investigation? And speaking of the FISA court, isn't your whole investigation premised on a fake dossier paid for by Hillary, created by a man who hates Donald Trump, and used to con a FISA court judge? Bob, I really think it's time for you to give up your phony investigation and get yourself your own criminal defense attorney. And that's my open.